In this video, I'm going to show you how to install Office 365 on an Apple iPhone. To get started, we're going to go into Settings. We'll scroll down and we're looking for Mail. So we're going to Mail, we're going to Accounts, and we click Add Account. At this screen, you might be forgiven for thinking that you're going to click on Outlook.com, but you're not. So what you actually want to go for is Microsoft Exchange. So we'll tap Microsoft Exchange, and we'll enter the email address. So our email address here is joe.soap@itsupportservice.co.uk, and this is just a description, this is just for your benefit. So we'll call this Office 365 Joe. Okay, we'll click Next. So we'll click Sign In. This takes us to the Microsoft login page on the internet. So we're going to now put the password in. This is the password that our system administrator gave to us for our Office 365 mailbox. Once we're done, we click Done, we click Sign In. You can choose whether to save that password or not. For now, I'm just going to say not now. So this is asking us to add these permissions to our phone, which we need to click Accept. And now we have the option to turn Mail on, Contacts on, Calendars, Reminders, and Notes. What this means is that the mailbox will synchronize with the Office 365 system. So will the contacts list and your calendar and reminders and notes. So in particular, your mail, contacts, and calendar are the things you're probably going to use the most. That's going to synchronize with what you see on your desktop computer or your laptop in Microsoft Outlook. So normally we'll just leave all these switches turned on and we click Save. Now you can see that we've got two email accounts in here. One was already here, and that was the iCloud account. The second one is the one we've just added. Now we're going to make sure that the default mail account, the default calendar account, and the default contacts account relate to the same account that you see in Outlook on your computer. And the way that we do this is to go back to the main menu, back up to Settings. The first one we'll do is Mail. We click on Mail and we scroll down, and you see right at the bottom it says default account. And at the moment that's set to our iCloud account, which is wrong. So we're going to click on default account and we're going to change it to our Office 365 account. And then when we click Mail in the top left hand corner and then Settings, that comes back up to this main menu. We do the same thing for contacts and calendars. So we go into Contacts, we go to default account, we'll change it to Office 365, and we come back up and we go into calendar and we do the same in calendar. Default calendar, and we're going to, you see how there's a grey heading above each of these white blocks. The heading at the top says Office 365 Joe and the heading at the bottom says iCloud. So at the moment our default calendar is the home calendar within the iCloud account. What we actually need to set it to is this green dot here, which is calendar within the Office 365 Joe account. You'll see on your own when you do this, you'll get a similar format. Usually you get the birthdays calendar and the national holidays calendar as part of Office 365. You just need to be choosing the one that just says calendar. So we'll tap that and then we'll come out of that menu, and that is it. We're set up. So if we now go to our home page, and we go to mail, you'll see that we've got in our mailbox list, we've got all inboxes, which will show us all of the emails, whether they arrived in the iCloud account or the Office 365 account. Or we can select the inbox, the mailbox for iCloud or the mailbox for Office 365 Joe. Just for now, we're going to click on Office 365 Joe, and you'll see that we've got our Office 365 mailbox is in there. If we click New Mail at the bottom, this just allows us to type a new email. If once we've clicked Send, it will save it to the sent items, and if you have a look on your computer, you'll find that message is in your sent items within a few seconds. Let's just cancel on that. If we go back to the home page, if we then go to Calendar, when we click the plus in the top right hand corner and we put in a test calendar entry and we click Add, that calendar is green and corresponds with the green on our list here, and you can see that the green one is our Office 365 Joe account. So now that we've got our test calendar entry in there, that will appear on your computer as well. And that's it. So our mail, contacts and calendars will now synchronize between Outlook on your computer and our iPhone. If you found this video helpful, please consider sharing it with your colleagues and friends, as they are likely to find it helpful too. If you haven't already, please click like if you've enjoyed this video, and please subscribe to our channel.